Welcome back. We'll start the new topic, that is ventilation. Ventilation is not only means the replacement of ventilated air by a supply of fresh outdoor air, but also control of the quality of incoming air with regard to its temperature, humidity, and purity, with a view to provide a thermal environment that is comfortable and free from risk of infection. It is not just the supply of outdoor air, fresh outdoor air. It also means that like maintaining the quality of air regard to the its temperature, humidity, and how pure it is. There are certain standards for the ventilation. Okay, most of the standards of ventilation have been based on the efficiency of ventilation in removing body odor. First one, the cubic space. Minimal fresh air supply ranging from 300 to 3000 cubic feet per hour per person. In the home, the 300 to 3000 cubic feet per hour, that area should be kept for one person, okay, for the fresh air. D. Chamant advocated a fresh air supply of 3000 cubic feet per person per hour. So the person, D. Chamant, he advocated a person should get 3000 cubic feet fresh air in a hour. Second one, air change. Air change is more important than the cubic space requirement. Okay, it is recommended that in the living rooms there should be 2 to 3 air changes in 1 hour. In workrooms and assemblies there should be 4 to 6 air changes. If the air change is changed more frequently, that is more than 6 times in 1 hour, it is likely to produce a draught and should be avoided. The number of air changes per hour is calculated by dividing the total hour air supply to the room by the cubic capacity of the room. A space of 1000 to 1200 cubic feet per person is quite sufficient. Air change means how much fresh air, pure air, or the good ventilation is getting by a person in an hour. That is air change. Okay, so there should, in the living room there should be at least 2 to 3 air changes, and in the rooms, bigger rooms or work rooms and assemblies, there should be 4 to 6 air changes. Okay, if it is changed more frequently, it will produce a draught. Okay, that should be avoided. So there should be normal, not maximum or not minimum, there should be normal air change in an hour. A space of 1,000-1,200 cubic feet per person is quite sufficient in a living room. Okay. Third one is floor space. Floor space per person is even more important than cubic space. Okay. The optimum floor space requirement per person vary from 50 to 100 square feet. So, if the person is living in one room, 50 to 100 square feet, 100 square feet of the area should be covered by a person. Only one person should occupy this area, that is floor space. Next one is type of ventilation. There are different types of ventilation. First one is natural ventilation. Natural ventilation is the simplest system of ventilating small dwellings, schools and offices. Okay. First one is by the wind. The wind is an active force in ventilation. When it blows through a room, it is called perfusion. Okay, it will blow through a room and it is called as perfusion. Due to this force, there will be an air exchange, there will be a supply of pure ventilation. Second one is diffusion. Air passes through the smallest opening or spaces by diffusion. Okay, so the tiny space is also enough for the exchange of air. This is a slow process and therefore it is not relied upon as the sole means of ventilation. So it is not a sole means of ventilation. There should be a window or door or an active transport of a ventilation. Third one is inequality of temperature. Okay, air flows from the high density to low density. Everyone knows this. So, and it is also blows from the high pressure area to the low pressure area. the greater the temperature difference between the outside and inside air, the greater the velocity of the incoming air. So wherever the temperature changes are more, there will be a more force in the change of the air. These properties of air are utilized to best advantage of by the proper location of windows, doors, ventilators and skylights. The chief drawback of natural ventilation is that it is not possible to regulate the velocity. The velocity cannot be regulated. It is natural how when the temperature varies, the equal amount of the force will be drawn, and by this force the air will be drawn into the room. Next one is mechanical ventilation. Okay, there are types, four types: exhaust ventilation, plenum ventilation, balanced ventilation and air conditioning. First one is about exhaust ventilation, also called as exhaust fan. In this system, air is extracted or exhausted to the outside by exhaust fans driven by electricity. So exhaust fan will be kept near the window or the near the wall, so that inside air will be pushed outside the room, so that good air will be drawn into the room through the door or a window. As air is exhausted, a vacuum is created in the room, which induces fresh air to enter the room through windows, doors and other inlets. Exhaust ventilation is generally provided in large halls, auditorium for removal of vitiated air. The exhaust fans are housed in apparatus in the external walls, high up near the roof, which facilitate a good ventilation. So, in the room, it is kept in the higher level of the room or a wall, so that all the impure air will be pushed outside. Next one is plenum ventilation. In this system, fresh air is blown into the room by centrifuge fans so as to create a positive pressure and displace the vitiated air. Plenum or propulsion. So here there will be propulsion fans, what we call the centrifugal fans. When it rotates, there will be a creation of positive pressure. Through this, the outside air will be drawn into the room and all the impure or vitiated air will be pushed outside of the room. Plenum is used for supplying air to air conditioned buildings and factories. Air is delivered through ducts as desired points. Okay, through any ducts or a pipeline or anything, or any means of transportation can be used for the good ventilation. Next, third one is balanced ventilation. This is a combination of the exhaust and plenum systems of ventilation. The blowing fan must balance the exhaust fan. So inside there will be a blowing fan, and near the wall there will be exhaust fan. When exhaust fan rotates, all the force the vacuum is created in the room, all the air will be pushed outside, impure air will be pushed outside, so that there will be another, that is plenum ventilation. Plenum fan also used. By this, the good air is drawn into the room. The last one is air conditioning. Air conditioning is defined as the simultaneous control of all, which will control everything, not only air, which will also control temperature, humidity, air movement, distribution, dust, bacteria, odors and toxic gases, most of which affect in greater or lesser degree the human health and comfort. So this everything will be controlled by AC or air conditioning. Air conditioning is popular in large institutions, hospital, industries and dwellings. Its use in operation theater is of particular value in control of pathogenic organisms in the air. So operation theater, it is used to kill some of the harmful bacteria. Large institutions or hospitals often install central air conditioning system for entire building, where the temperature difference is large between outside atmosphere and air conditioned room. Transition room is sometimes provided. See, there be a huge difference between the outside temperature and inside temperature, that is called air conditioned temperature. So in between there will be a transition room where people can sit for some time and they can they can adapt to the environment. Okay, there will be a that is not air conditioned as well as it is not highly hot like other outside area. So that is called transition room where people can adapt to the temperature. So that's all about the ventilation. We'll see in the next chapter. Thank you.